Lesson 9, review. I don't do a specific review lesson all that often. The issue is, all these equations look similar. What's that you say, Mr. Duick? Would it be wise to have my formula sheet handy and in front of me to help reinforce what goes with what?
Why, that's a brilliant idea. That's good studying. I like that idea.
To solve correctly, first of all, make sure you convert to coulombs. The two biggest ones are going to be microcoulomb and occasionally a millicoulomb. But certainly one microcoulomb is 1 times 10 to the negative 6 coulombs. Or if I'm talking about charges and I mention a proton or an electron, the elementary charge, what is the elementary charge on an electron? Really? I have no idea, but it sounded right. 6, 7, 9. What was that, Curtis? To the negative 19? It's the mass you're thinking of. And a proton, positive 1.6 times 10 to the negative 19. Each of these particles has a different mass. That's also on your formula sheet. You'll use that for forces or for kinetic energy. So, example 2, I said, solve for the correct quantity, fill in the variables and the units in the column. But you know what? Here's a little chart. We're going to carefully go through this row by row. Okay? So, the quantity, variable unit, force. What's the variable that we use for force? You've known this for a while. What letter? F. Measured in units. Newtons. What about for electric field? We're going to do the first column first. What about for electric field? What's the variable for electric field? The variable. What letter on our formula sheet is electric field? E, capital E. And the units, William, what was the first one? Or, there's a second one that works as well. Volts per meter. What's the variable for PE, for potential energy? I prefer to use PE. You'll notice I've done that since physics 11. That's wrong, by the way. It's very bad manners to use two capital letters for one quantity. Really, every time I write this, that should mean momentum times energy or momentum times electric field. It should mean P times E. The reason I don't is specifically for this unit. I will use PE. What does your sheet use? The only problem is kids get that E confused with electric field E, so I don't like it. What are the units for potential energy? Hasn't changed much. Joules. Voltage. What's another word for voltage? Potential. What Elijah's mom says he has. Potential. Right? Symbol for potential. I tend to put the wings on there to show that's a capital V. Units. Well, what do you measure voltage in? Volts. What does that break down to, though? Based on the voltage definition, what does a volt break down to? Look at where volts is defined.
energy, which is measured in per?
Volts is really joules per coulomb.
Last one is work. What letter have we been using for work? W.
And it's measured in joules.
Okay. The potential, no pun intended, for mistakes is getting E and E mixed up and getting potential and potential energy mixed up. How to find the direction. How do you find the direction of the force on an object? It's a vector, so it has a direction. Did you put in the signs? Did you put in the plus signs and the minus signs?
Nope.
How did we find the direction? We used two rules. What were the two rules? Like? What do like charges do?
Unlike charges attract.
Okay. Electric field was also a vector. So again, don't put in positive and negative signs. That whole first row, forget the signs. Forces and fields, first row on your formula sheet, forget the signs. Lots of F's in there on purpose. How do you figure out the direction of the electric field?
Which way would plus VE, that's my abbreviation for positive, charge move?
The way I always phrase, which way would a positive charge want to move if it could? A tiny positive test charge. How tiny? So tiny that it hasn't have its own electric field. That was the whole rant that I always went through. But yeah, which really means from positive to negative, and I know some textbooks just teach it that way, so all the kids, which way is electric field? And they all parrot back, from positive to negative. The problem is, what if you only have a negative or you only have a positive in your picture? I think it's easier to say, well, now I can imagine which way a positive charge would want to go, because like repel and like attract. What's the direction of potential energy? Oh, it's a scalar. Which means you better include plus or minus signs. Scalars include signs. What about voltage? How do I figure out the direction of voltage? Also a scalar, so no direction, which means you also include the plus or minus signs. What about work? Work, scalar or vector? How do you know? You're right. How do you know? Joules, energy. Energy is definitely a scalar. Work is a scalar. Work isn't going to have charges in it, so I'm not going to freak about it, signs or not. But
The one you'll probably use the most for work in this unit is change in potential plus change in kinetic. So now we have a couple of situations, point charges and parallel plates. Now we're going to do the entire first row, forces. How do I calculate the force between two point charges? Okay, Q1, Q2, over R squared. Direction, like repel, unlike attract. Look at the diagram, figure it out. How do I figure out the force between parallel plates? MA, nope, that's Newton's law. That works for anything, but what about electric force between parallel plates?
What's the other equation that has an F in it?
QE. Oh, where E is the electric field. Little note. E is the voltage divided by how far apart the plates are. How do I figure out the direction? Look at the plates. Ask yourself which one is more positive. That's the positive. The electric field would want to be in the negative direction. Figure it out. Got to look at your charge and look at the plates. But negative charges would want to move towards the more positive plate, the plate with the higher voltage. What if I have more than one charge? So what if I want to find the net force on that guy from the other two charges? We use the principle of superposition. We would add vectorially. Add them like vectors. Now, if they're in a nice straight line with each other, I might just have one force be to the left and one force be to the right, and I'd go winner minus loser. Or they might both be to the left in case it's winner plus winner. If they're at angles to each other, like this example here, you'll add them. How would you add vectors at angles to each other? Why, you would choose to draw them? Tip to tail. Tip to tail. What about electric fields? So I want to find in the next row, electric field between point charges and between parallel plates. Actually, you know what? We already did electric field between parallel plates. We said the electric field was equal to the voltage divided by the distance. How do I find the electric field between point charges or from one point charge? How? The other way, by the way, is if you know the force right there and you know the charge right there, you can get there too. In fact, that's how, William, we derived this force equation up here. We got the F by itself. It came from the actual definition of electric field, and the actual definition was how many newtons of force per every coulomb that's there. How would I add those two together vectorially? But you'll have to figure out what direction the electric field is in first. How will you figure out the direction? You'll ask which way would a positive want to move if it could. energy? Is that right? No, yes, yes? Okay. Between point charges, potential energy. Now that's what they use on their formula sheet, EP. Sorry, I like. It's going to be K, Q1, Q2 over R, right? And you'll include the plus and minus signs. A negative answer doesn't mean that you have somehow backwards or negative potential energy. It means relative to zero at infinity, you'll have to add some energy to get to zero to get out to the to infinity. What's the potential energy between plates? Yes. Blatantly on your formula sheet? Not quite. You have to rearrange the energy voltage equation, right? And again, you put the signs in positive and negatives. What if you were finding the net potential energy right there? Do you have to add them vectorially? No. They're just scalars. So add them up. What about voltage? Voltage only comes from one charge. Can come from more, but only needs to come from one. How can I figure out the voltage from a point charge? KQ over R. Again, it's a scalar, include plus minus signs. Can I have a negative voltage? All that means is each charge in that location has a negative amount of energy, negative relative to a zero at infinity. How do I find, why don't I write PE, Mr. Duick? I wrote potential. That better, folks? How do I find the voltage between plates? Well, if it's between plates, it's going to be labeled, I hope, the plates have the voltage on them. Otherwise, well, what other equations have voltage in them? Sorry? E times T? D? Say that again. D, I'm sorry, I missed it. So is that what you're saying?
Yeah.
Sorry, I missed. It was all those E sounds, and I couldn't get which letters you're referring to. Sure. I don't know if I've used that, but sure. Anything else has voltage in it?
Potential.
Well, yeah, I guess voltage is always how much energy per coulomb. But often, it'll just be labeled. How would I add these voltages together? You know what? Scalar. So once again, add. Last one. Work. Sadly, between point charges, work is that much. It's change in potential plus change in kinetic. What's changed anything? Final minus initial. Between point charges, why can't I use force times distance between point charges? This force isn't constant. Where is force constant? Between plates. That would work if I knew the force. Oh, QE times D. Where the electric field is change in voltage over, you know what? Good enough. Okay. Oh, and I'm not going to give you a work tip to tail scalar vector thingy. Continuing on. So, a couple of more things. Making sure that I went over all my little tips and pointers. Let me see. Come on. So, I said, make sure you use the correct point charge parallel plate formulas. You know what? If it's got an R in it, that's radius. That's for circular point charges. Some of the other ones are more generic. Make sure you correctly assign the vector direction for force and field, no direction for potential energy or voltage, but include the signs. Make sure you calculate point charge work using energy and not using force. So to find the work for point charges, I use change in potential plus change in kinetic. I can't use force times distance. I can between plates. So reason why we can't use force times distance and must use, oh, why can't we use force times distance for point charges? Why can't we? Right? Between point charges, as soon as you move, the force has changed. Between point charges, but is constant. Constant between plates. Says reason why we can calculate parallel plate work using either force times distance or change. The change in energy works for both. Ah, but since the force is constant between the plates, if you happen to have the force, go force times distance. And then add vectors to find the total force or field. Add scalars to find the total potential energy or voltage. So, whew, let's try some. What can I ask you to do? Example 7 says, for the charge system below, find A, the force, magnitude, and direction on the positive charge. B, find the voltage at the dot. C, find the work required to bring that 4.75 times 10 to the negative 8 Coulomb charge from infinity and get it to bring it in all the way right at that dot. Okay. How much room did I leave us? Oh, fair bit. Let's see. Force. Which equation am I going to use? K, Q1, Q2 over R squared. Let's call this Q1. Let's call that Q2. Nine times 10 to the ninth. 1.5 microcoulombs. 4.2 microcoulombs. All over what? Ah, good. Did you hear him? He made the mistake that I was hoping he would make and caught himself. 36. Ah, first of all, I got to get the total distance between them, so add the 12 and the 24 centimeters. Nice try, Duick. 0.36. Harjot? Knock, knock. Squared! Sorry. I believe you've gotten that joke wrong occasionally in the past, so we'll bring it up, yes? Wrong punchline for that joke, Mr. Duick. 9 times 10 to the 9th, 1.5, 4.2, divided by 0.36 squared. Do you get that? Okay. 0.438, if I go to 3 sig figs, newtons. Direction. Oh, and it wants the direction on the positive charge. So I will have to tell you which charge we happen to be focusing on so you know direction. So that positive charge, which way will it be feeling a force? Left, right, up, or down? Oh, because unlike charges, attract. Left. What else could I ask you to find from this configuration? I could ask you to find the net electric field at the dot. I didn't, but I will. Could also ask you, part B, find the voltage right there. The voltage is going to be the voltage from charge 1 combined with the voltage from charge 2. Which voltage equation am I going to use? Mm-hmm. Hopefully this is all coming together now. Heck, point charge, KQ1 over R1 plus KQ2 over R2. It's going to be, you know what, I'm going to need a line. 9 times 10 to the 9th. Oh, am I including a negative here or not? Voltage? Yes. Negative 1.5 microcoulombs. And R1 is 0.12 plus 9 times 10 to the 9th. Positive 4.2 microcoulombs. All over 0.24. I'd probably do each one of these one at a time. So I'm going to go 9, negative 1.5, divided by 0.12. The left-hand voltage is negative 112,500. The right-hand voltage is... delete 4.2, 157,500. So the net voltage, the total voltage, is that plus negative 112,500, 45,000 volts. Positive or negative? Positive. Nate, what's part C want us to find? Sorry? Okay. Point charges. I guess work is going to be and change in anything is going to be... Now, on your test, I would specifically include the phrase from a very long distance away. This question didn't include that phrase, but it kind of implies it. It says, how much work to bring in this third charge? I think we're starting out at infinity. I think we can say we started out with no potential energy. Now... one way to do this, I'm bringing in a third charge right there called charge 3. I could find the change in potential energy by finding potential energy between those two, K, Q1, Q2 over R1 equals, and potential energy between those two, K, Q1, K, Q2, Q3 over R equals, and then add them up. We'll get you there. Anybody see a better way, especially based on what I just found in part B? Yeah. I think you're right. You said you can go potential energy equals Q. Yeah, you know what? It's going to be the charge that you're moving, which is charge 3, times the voltage at that location. Or, by the way, if this first voltage wasn't zero, if this first initial wasn't zero, I could just find the change in voltage, and I could say Q change in voltage, and I'm also done, which is way faster than recrunching this 4 or 5 times. How big is the charge that I'm moving? Positive 4.75 times 10 to negative 8. Times 45,000 times positive 4.78. By the way, the voltage at that location, Ashley, was it positive or negative? The charge that we're moving in, is it positive or negative? Does this charge really want to go to that positive voltage? No. Will I have to do work to get it to go there? Yes. So I'm expecting a positive answer? Yes. I will have to add that much energy. 2.15 times 10 to the negative 3 joules. Is that okay, Petra? Right? Is that okay? Thumbs up. These are some of the questions I can throw at you with a couple of point charges. Hey, what are some of the more questions I can throw at you with plates? The TV, the cathode ray tube. Okay? So below, now these are really tough to do because I'm using a two-dimensional piece of paper and my terrible graphics skills to represent a three-dimensional object. So you got to use your imagination. Below is a side view and a front view of a cathode ray tube screen. So the observer is sitting in a chair right there. Their eye is right there. They're looking that way. Okay? The electron beam right now, before we turn anything on, is hitting dead center of the screen. We haven't turned on any of the plates yet, aside from the accelerating voltage. Question one. Where will the electron dot end up? Choose from A, B, C. Choose from all the different possibilities here. If we, one, make the upper deflecting plate positive. If I make, don't write this down, I'll just change it. If I make that positive, where will this beam, based on where the observer is sitting, where will that beam move to? A, B, C, or D, or E. Peter. Oh, because the electron as it goes through is going to get tugged up. It's going to hit somewhere up there. So I agree, A. What if, okay, shut it off. Start over. What if I make the right plate positive? So let me erase this. What if I make that positive, what will the observer see? A, B, C, D, or E? Again, think you're sitting in the chair looking this way so that that's the right side of the screen, that's the left side of the screen. If you make the right plate positive, it'll pull the electron Peter, into the page from this guy's view. I think it'll pull it to the right. B, yes? Okay. Third possibility. What if we make both the right plate and the upper plate positive? Where will that put it? You see it, folks? E, right? Going to deflect it up and right. And I hope what you're seeing, Jordan, is this is that we can put an electron anywhere we want to. And by strengthening or lowering the voltage, not only can we change the direction, but how far it's deflected by. We can put a dot anywhere we want to. Now we can start to create a little, paint a little image. Okay, now start over. This time, we adjust the voltage so that the electron beam is hitting a point above the middle of the screen because the upper plate is already positive. In other words, now, Cliff, we've got a dot hitting right there, just above center. Where will the new dot end up? Choose from A, B, D, C, F, G. What if I increase the deflecting voltage? What'll happen? G. Same direction, but bigger deflection. Reset it back to the way it was originally, so the beam is being deflected slightly up. What if I reverse the polarity of the deflecting voltage? In other words, I make the bottom positive. What will that do? C. What if we increase the accelerating voltage? What do you think that would do? Okay. It's not in the plates for as long. It doesn't get deflected as much because it's not in there for as long a time. A. So another way we can control the deflection isn't just with the deflecting plates, it's also with our accelerating plates. Callum, this really gives us pinpoint control with 1920s technology. This lesson was way cooler 8 years ago when all of your TVs actually worked like this, because then I'd be seeing kids, and that's why I have to wait for it to warm, and sometimes there's a little dot in the middle, stupid flat screens. No, I like technology, no, stupid flat screens. It says, explain your answer using principles of physics. We just did. So, in what way does our simple model of a cathode ray tube explain how black and white TV works? So only one dot pixel is hit at a time. By sweeping the Y voltage positive to negative, we can move the beam up and down across the screen. And the way they do it is essentially, first you do all of that row, then you step the deflecting left-right voltage up a tiny bit, you do all of that section, then you step the deflecting voltage to the right a bit more. Basically, it paints the screen in that way, really, really fast. And then start over. Really, really fast, 60 times a second. That's plenty fast enough that your eyes won't catch it. Not quite fast enough that a camera's shutter speed can't sometimes catch it. And you've noticed that. We said if you're watching, especially if you're watching the news, for example, and they're interviewing somebody and there's a computer in the background, you'll often see the computer, it looks like their screen is going all haywire. No, it's just the different cycles happen to be interlacing with each other. So if we gradually add increments of X voltage, then sweep vertically, we can illuminate the entire screen. The TV signal turns the cathode ray, the CRT beam on and off as it sweeps the screen. Beam on is a white dot, beam off is a black dot. Beam partially on, so fewer electrons, is a gray dot. Picture. For color TV, we saw the video yesterday. All they have are three electron guns, and you'll notice they get clever. They also put a sheet with very tiny dots in it to make sure that if the electrons aren't quite lined up, they won't make it to the screen and put a dot in the right location. That sheet screens out any stray electrons. There it is, electrostatics. Homework. Yep. Half an hour, so take home quiz for sure. If you're looking for good kind of review questions, two. Three. Four. Five is cool, but meh. An electron beam is accelerated. Nah. Seven is good. 9, I like number 9, I like number 9, I like number 9. Number 9 is a nice question. Kind of cool, but no. Ooh. That's tempting. 12 is really cool and theoretical. Sure, let's try 12. Projectiles. 15 is a review of momentum, so it says this. A 700 kilogram mass is moving at 12 meters per second. It explodes, boom, into two 350 kilogram pieces, which travel in the same direction as the original piece, one moving 8 meters per second faster than the other. How much energy was released? See if you can figure that one out. That one's a little bit tricky, but it's a nice review of explosions, momentum, and some energy. Really? You really? What did you think I was reading the question out for? Really? Oh, boy.